Hello, this is a comparison video between the Pelican M805 Blue Dunes to the Sailor 1911 Large in the demonstrator version. They're both in fine nibs. This is a Western nib, this is a Japanese nib, so there's obviously going to be variation in nib size, nib width, which you'll see. Okay, let's get into just the overall comparison. As you can see, they're pretty much the same width when it comes to cap, but on the body itself, I think the M805 is a little bit more girthier. But in terms of the length, they're pretty much the same size. The clip of the M805, you see the Pelican clip. This is spring loaded. This is pretty stiff. So is the Sailor. They're both very useful, practical. Then on the band, on the Pelican says Pelican, Sovereign Range, Germany, whereas on this says Sailor, Japan, founded 1911. This is a piston converter, this is a cartridge converter, it's one of the major differences. You open it up, you have the nib sections where the Pelican M805 is more. Not more girthier, but flares out more, so it's more comfortable for me. But they're both great. So you have the 1911 large nibs, gold nib, 21 karat gold nib, fine. This is the Pelican M805. This is the silver trim, 18 karat gold nib, which is also fine. As you can see, the M805 nib is a little bit bigger, not just in terms of length, but in width as well. And you have more ridges on the Sailor 1911 compared to this, but they're not as sharp at all, so they're both comfortable. You can post both of these pens. I don't post my pens, but you can post them. The M85 becomes way too long for me, but yeah, as you can see, they're both very balanced, made out of resin, so very comfortable to hold both of them. So can't go wrong with writing with them for hours and hours. Same thing for the Sailor 1911 Large. They're both very comfortable. Now, before we get into writing sample, I want to get into what I like and what I don't like about these pens. Before we do that, I'm just going to do some size comparisons. You have the Custom A23 and 1000. Visconti Homo sapiens condition. I mean, these are all way big pens. Custom Urushi, Yukari Royale. So in terms of pen size, I mean, this is in the moderate range. I like a little bit bigger pens as well. So it's, you're not going wrong with the size. Pretty much most people prefer this size than the big sizes of like the Visconti Homo sapiens or M1005. But yeah, so now let's get into what I like and what I don't like about this pen. So in terms of just overall, I go into more in the brand sample, but this has more feedback, so I'm not the biggest fan of having too much feedback on my nibs, but this has a singing type feedback that Sailor is known for, which is enjoyable but in moderate amounts, so I don't use this as much. I use occasionally when I don't want to write just smooth pens, when I just want to feel my pen writing, I just want to hear it. Whereas with this, I use all the time because it's a smooth nib, barely any feedback, just feedback that just lets you know you're writing. And yeah, I also like the demonstrated version of this. One of the things I just don't like is just how it's demonstrated, but then this is like grayed out, which kind of like makes it like off. Kind of like takes away from the overall look of it, but still great. One of the things I like the most about this demonstrator is that there's no ink spill on the nib section. With most demonstrators like the Custom 74, which kind of annoys me. It might not annoy you, but just my personal opinion on that. But yeah, this pen is, they're both great. This holds a lot more ink. And this is a cartridge converter, so it's easy to clean. But this is also very easy to clean because you can take out the nip section for pelicans, so you can easily clean the piston, like clean this up very fast. And you don't clean it as much because it has a lot of incapacity anyways, but it's more convenient. But this is as convenient because cartridge converter, but doesn't have any much incapacity. You'll be filling it up a lot more if you care about incapacity as much. But I don't, that's why I had this pen. I bought both these pens with my own money, so in terms of the prices, I paid about $176 for this and about $340 for this. So this is way more expensive. And I think this is a special edition, so the price goes up for that. I bought them both brand new. So but if you buy them pre-owned, it's worth it. And even at $340, I think this is a great value for this pen. Special edition. It's limited production, not special. Like, it's not limited edition, if that makes sense. But yeah, these are both great pens. You can't go wrong with them. And the writing experience of this is just amazing. So is this. It just depends on your preference. I prefer to use this as much more because it has less sound type feedback, like with Sailors, but I still like them. So I use them like once or twice a week compared to like nibs like these that I use all the time. But yeah, thank you for watching. Now let's get into the writing sample. Let's get into the writing sample of the Sailor 1911 Large Demonstrator version versus Amido 5 Blue Dunes, and they're both fine nibs. Now let's get started. I'll start with the Pelican Amido 5. This is a very smooth nib. Barely hear any feedback. Ink is organic brown by Caran d'Ache. One of my favorite inks, if not favorite. There's some line variation, but not much. This is a stiff nib compared to the M1000. And in terms of wetness, this is a medium. I mean, it's not a dry pen, but it's not a gusher either, which I like. I like a medium-sized wetness. Now, let's get into the Sailor 1911 Large. Demonstrator, fine nib as well. Now the ink, is Emerald Chivor by J. Herbin. The anniversary version. Now you can hear the feedback on this because of the pencil type feedback that Sailors are known for. There's no line variation with this. This is a stiff nib, even as a 21 karat gold nib. And this is a dry pen as well, as you can see. So the thing is, with this Sailor 1911, the feedback is pencil type, but it is not unpleasant. So there's a difference. Even if it feels like a kind of a nail type, but you don't feel any scratches. It's just rather just you hear this pencil type feedback, which I really like. Whereas the Pelican Mate 05 is smooth as butter, and it's not soft, but it is smooth. The M1000 is soft, but it's very enjoyable. So if you want some type of feedback on your pen, then I would go with the Sailor 1911 Large. But if you want like smooth with slight feedback, that's just letting you know you're writing, then I would go with the Pelican Mate 05. They're both in fine nib, and I enjoy them both. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.